Hi, I'm Reed Tellinghuisen, and I started 127 games for the men's basketball team and made the second most threes in school history. Please join me for another episode of A Decade of Excellence.
Ebert has the right wing for three on the mark. Banked it, good for three!
Seth Gross is a champion.
Kick out Tellinghuisen for three to answer. Yes!
Strobler did not reach the end zone on fourth and short.
My senior year is unmatched when it comes to overall success. 10 All-Americans, 7 Conference Players of the Year, and 5 Summit League titles. Football made its deepest postseason run, earning a top 8 seed in the FCS playoffs and reaching the national semifinals. Wide receiver Jake Winicky became the program's first 4-time All-American. He ended his career second in FCS history with 59 touchdown catches and third in receiving yards with 5,157. He was also chosen as one of 22 individuals in all of college football to the Good Works team. Jacob Onosorgi won the Remington Award, which is presented to the best center in all of college football. Dallas Goedert received All-American accolades after putting together the best season of any tight end in the country. He was drafted in the second round by the NFL's Philadelphia Eagles. Two sophomores, linebacker Christian Rosenbaum and kicker Chase Vinatieri, also received All-American honors. And two other football players were academic All-Americans, linebacker Dalton Cox and offensive lineman Wes Genant. Men's cross country claimed the Summit League championship for the 6th time in 11 years, and 3 of the top 4 finishers were Jackrabbits. In fact, both the men's and women's races were won by Jacks. Chase Kao was the men's champion, while Rachel King won the women's event, and each were named Cross Country Athlete of the Year. Meanwhile, Rod DeHaven earned yet another Coach of the Year award. Soccer allowed only one goal the entire regular season en route to a conference championship. The stout defense led to Maggie Smither receiving Goalkeeper of the Year and Annie Williams Defensive Player of the Year. Head coach Brock Thompson was also honored by the Summit. The success kept rolling in the winter. 7 wrestlers qualified for the NCAA championships, with 3 finishing in the top 8 to earn All-American status. Luke Zilverberg was 8th at 157 pounds, David Kosher took 7th at 174, and Seth Gross finished off a magical season by winning the national title at 133 pounds, ending his junior year with a 29-1 record. Women's basketball had another fantastic season. It defeated nationally ranked North Carolina State and Big 12 Oklahoma. And Maddie Giebert had 2 tremendous buzzer-beating threes.
Alexander gets the ball. Alexander looking over to Giebert for the win. She's got it! Got it! Madison Giebert! Can a miracle happen in Notre Dame? Luck of the Irish, selling to Macy Miller at midcourt with 4, with 3, with 2. Giebert at the right wing for 3 on the mark. Banked it, good for 3! Tied at 68! We're going to overtime!
Macy Miller was Conference Player of the Year, and the woman won the Summit League tournament, never trailing USD in the title tilt. Our men's team lost only once in the last 3 months of the season, winning the Summit League regular season and tournament titles. And we were undefeated here at Frost Arena, one of the best home courts in all of college basketball. We beat Iowa on the Grand Cayman Island, won at Ole Miss in December, and ran through the conference, winning the tournament for a 3rd straight time. Mike Dom was again All-America, while receiving his 2nd consecutive Conference Player of the Year award. Softball had its best season in history, behind the league's Coach of the Year, Crystal Wood. They won 37 games and advanced to the NISC tournament behind Brittany Morris's phenomenal season. She hit 396 with 61 runs batted in to win the Summit League Player of the Year. Track and field collected 19 Summit League event titles. Rachel King led the way with the 3,000 meter and the mile indoors. Outdoors, she earned All-America honors by winning the 3,000 as well. Bryant Corder was the triple jump champion in both the indoor and outdoor, while also claiming the outdoor long jump. Chase Kao won the 5,000 indoor and 10,000 outdoor, and Kyle Burdick claimed both the 3,000 and the mile at the indoor event. In the classroom, distance runner Haley Meckles was an academic All-American. That was a lot to get through. Now let's catch our breath and run through the highlights one more time. We had 10 All-Americans and 3 academic All-Americans, winning 5 conference titles along the way, 111 all-conference athletes, 258 academic all-leaguers, 7 conference players of the year, and a cumulative grade point average of 3.298. What a remarkable 12 months that was, but we aren't through yet. There's one more year to cover, and we'll do that next time, so stay tuned. And remember, go big, go blue, go Jacks.